Today in the news, we've got a lot of AMD PCB and some more Intel bad news. What's up guys, I'm Snows and this is your boot sequence. Let's get started with AMD. It looks like the PCB of an upcoming AMD Navi GPU has been spotted by Komachi on Twitter. Now, we don't know exactly what Navi card this PCB is made for, but we can make some educated guesses. Let's dive into it. First, let's just clean up the PCB so we can focus on what I'm talking about. It's a little simple, but it will work for what I want to do. The first thing we can see is the clear space made for GDDR memory. All around the GPU area, there is space for 8 individual memory modules, and those appear to be GDDR6. We can tell that by the number of connection points on the module. GDDR5 has 170, or 5x17, GDDR5X has 190, or 5x19, and GDDR6 has 180, or 5x18. Unlike Vega, AMD confirmed almost a year ago that Navi could work very well with both GDDR6 and HBM2, and that they were fully committed to both. That makes sense since Navi will be on the PS5, and I don't think HBM2 for a console is really an option. This is our first hint that this is actually a Navi PCB and not a Vega refresh. With the number of modules available, we can also tell that Navi will have a 256-bit memory bus. Now, AMD always used really wide bandwidth for their GPUs, no matter the model, so that doesn't really surprise me. Then there is, of course, the power delivery. As we know, the first generation Vega was very, very power hungry. And with the Radeon 7 with Vega 2, while definitely better thanks to the 7nm process, still consumes a lot of power compared to Nvidia cards. So how about Navi? Well, if we look at the PCB, we can see a 2x8-pin power configuration. That coupled with the 8-phase VRM config points towards this card consuming quite a lot. I think that this is probably the highest mid-range Navi PCB. Now, this could be just an engineering sample and maybe we'll see the final product with a lighter pin config, but I wouldn't hold my breath on that. While AMD has been clear that power efficiency is one of their top priorities, they also considered the power efficiency of Vega 2 as, and I quote, fantastic. So while this card probably won't consume as much as a Radeon 7, there is a chance that Navi won't be all that efficient in comparison to Nvidia GPUs. For all I know though, this might be a huge leap in power efficiency for AMD. Then there is the cooling. The pattern of the 3 holes on the right side of the PCB is an indication of this card having a blower style cooler similar to the Vega 56 and 64. Personally, I don't mind it. Blower style coolers do have their advantages, and if you don't like them, third parties will have solutions available for you. BuildZoid assumes that this GPU will be in the range of 250 to 300 watts TDP because any higher and the card risks becoming a meme. I personally agree with that statement, although I don't think AMD will shy away from extra power with their track record. I'll leave a link to his analysis down below if you guys want to know a little more about the extras of that PCB. As usual, you gotta take all of this with a grain of salt since all we have is the PCB, but there isn't much happening on the AMD GPU side of things besides Navi, so I'm fairly confident in the info that was shared today. What do you guys think? Let me know down below. Moving on to Intel, last week their supposed roadmap until 2021 was leaked. Now, this was a roadmap made for commercial clients, and now we have a second one for the desktop clients through 2020. The main difference here is an accelerated timeline for Comet Lake S showing the 10-core SKUs coming in at Q1 next year for consumers. This unfortunately doesn't change anything for the future of 10 nanometers. It seems like we won't see them in our desktops until at least 2022. That's sad. Lastly, with Sony, it looks like the PS5 will not show its face in the first quarter of 2020. Most of the rumors were placing the PS5 for a March or a November release, but Sony confirmed to the investors that it wouldn't launch during this fiscal year, which means that it won't come out until after March of 2020. This means that the next generation console will probably launch for the holiday season of next year. I mean, that makes sense. Personally, with all that PS5 talk, I'm quite curious to see what Xbox has in stores. Come on, leakers, we need you on top of Microsoft too. Anyways, guys, that is pretty much it for the news today. Hopefully you've enjoyed. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to drop them in the comment section down below with the hashtag boot sequence. As always, you can click right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. Stay frosty, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Oh, I have to, oh. Oof, that was a powerful snap. for Sunday. That's the Sunday snap.